The following program was provided by an independent producer solely responsible for its content. The opinions expressed do not necessarily represent the views of this station, its staff, board of directors, or underwriters.
Hi everyone, welcome to Litchfield. I'm your host, John Latsha. On today's show, we're going to show you some creative mailboxes. All right, I drove around for hours and hours and hours trying to find these mailboxes, so I hope you enjoy the show. No mail, no bills. Yes! Okay, we found a pig. A pig mailbox. And Linda, the owner here, is gonna tell us all about it. Go ahead, Linda.
Well, I have lots of farm animals, and the pig is my favorite one. So I went to a man who does carvings down on, it's Naughty Pine, Naughty Designs, down on Route 27, West Epping.
Okay.
And he said, well, you have to bring me a model. So I actually found this little model of the pig, and I said, okay, make this, but make it as big as you can, and it has to be painted black and white.
So what does the postman say the first time that he saw this? Did he ring your doorbell and say, what's going on here with this?
They love it. Everybody, and we have so many people stop and take pictures, when they're trying to describe where we live, they go, oh, pig mailbox. They know right where you are.
So they love it, huh?
So that's how they know us, by the pig mailbox.
Well, thank you so much, Linda, for coming on. I really appreciate it.
Thank you, John.
Thank you. Okay, as you saw earlier on the show, we had a pig. Now we have this gigantic squirrel, and James is here to talk to us all about it. James?
Yes, hi. My wife's dad, Ken Blanchard, had it made years ago because Ken was always an outdoor enthusiast and liked to have unique things and never saw a mailbox made with a carving, although the carvings are popular in New Hampshire. But it gets a lot of attention, and Ken recently passed away, so now we're the proud owner of the house and the squirrel mailbox.
And do you have people coming by beeping and everything? You said they have a lot of attention.
Yeah, we get proximity and visibility on the road. It's become a permanent fixture of the town of Hudson. So yeah, we get a lot of attention with it.
All right, James, you're going to show us how to put the mail in here?
It actually does function as well quite easily. We have some magnets at the top. Easy open and closing.
Great. Thanks, James. I really appreciate you coming on.
My pleasure.
Thanks. Okay, everybody, do you think that I scored a touchdown finding this mailbox? Look at this beautiful thing here, a Patriots mailbox. I wonder what Bill Belichick would think about this box here, huh? What do you think? Hey, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to go over to their neighbor's house and see if they're a Jets fan. Okay, out of all the mailboxes that I've been to so far, and I've been cruising basically for hours, all right, for hours, and this is the most creative mailbox that I have seen, all right? And Mark, the owner, is going to tell us all about it. Go ahead, Mark.
Well, my wife and I were on a dog walk, and she decided she wanted a mailbox of a little guy, like holding something over its head. So after putting some scrap pipe together and cutting a couple of pieces with my son, it took about 8 hours of time, a little creativity, and there's your mailbox.
Now you got the legs here, and you got the kneecaps, and the head, and the arms. Wow.
And a little copper flake finish.
Copper flake finish, it makes it stand out a lot, huh? So how long did it take you to put it all together and finally
probably about 8 hours.
8 hours.
Yeah.
Wow. Well, it's very, very creative, and I really appreciate you showing us all.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Okay, that's our show for today. I hope everybody enjoyed it. I'm your host, John Latcher, and that's in Litchfield. Now, how many of you think that there's going to be a bill in my mailbox? How many? Raise your hand. Let's go take a look. Bill. Bill. Can't these people ever leave me alone?